Hey, Scott Klosowski here. This is my home office, and odds are high if you're watching this now, you're in your home office. This is the new reality that we're facing right now. For the first time, we've had a historical event that has driven many people home to work for now weeks at a time, possibly. What I'd like to do is pull out an interesting bit of work that we did almost 10 years ago, which was for a large client that wanted to understand what are the best practices for being able to lead home-based workers. Now, 10 years ago, we researched all over the world and came up with a list of 10 best practices. We pulled that work out a couple weeks ago, freshened it up a little bit, and we were amazed at how many of the ideas were still leading-edge ideas. Now, conceptually, what you have to understand as a leader is it's different running a team that are all dispersed than on-prem. The dynamics have changed. You can't communicate the same way. There are security issues that come up that were not the same when everybody was on-prem. How we turn in work, how we give out work to people, all of this needs to change slightly in order to be able to be productive when people are working from home. So if you're a leader listening to this right now, understand A, you've got to make some adjustments. B, you got to make a list of what the adjustments are. C, this is going to happen again. This will not be the last time we will move to a home-based working model. For that reason, we want to give you the resources as far as these 10 best practices. So feel free to click the link and go look at in more detail what are the 10 things. Hey, don't let us all down by being the kind of leader that's one-dimensional. You're only really good when people are physically around you. Gain the skill of switching back and forth so that you can then work with home-based workers in a way that is just as productive as if they're on-prem. All right, the world needs us. Let's be good leaders from this point forward.